Saçın ucun hörmezler, gülü solu dermezler sar gelin. Saçın ucun hörmezler, gülü solu dermezler sar gelin. Bu sevda ne sevdadı, seni mene vermezler. Neynim aman aman, neynim aman aman, sar gelin.
Thank you very much, Rauf. Hi everyone, I'm Nijat. Today we'll talk about Azerbaijan, its culture, Azerbaijani culture and Indian culture, and also how Azerbaijani community in Victoria has evolved over time. So I'll start first, I'll talk about Azerbaijan and I'll provide some interesting facts about it. So Azerbaijan is a post-Soviet country. It lies in Caucasus Mountains, just next to the biggest lake in the world, Caspian Sea. It has Russia on north, Turkey to the west, and Iran in the south. Azerbaijan has got around the population of around 10 million, and the capital city is Baku. And as I said, it's surrounded by around five countries. Its culture has been influenced very much by Turkic culture, obviously Russian culture because it's a post-Soviet country, and also Iranian culture. The biggest thing in Azerbaijan, the biggest thing in the market of Azerbaijan is oil. Actually, almost 90% of exports of Azerbaijan is oil, and the first oil drilling actually occurred in Baku, the capital city of Azerbaijan, in 1850s. And Azerbaijan played a very important role of in World War II, supplying essential oil to the troops of the Soviet Union. Actually, some interesting facts about oil. The Nobel brothers, the establishers of Nobel Prize, they actually made almost all their money in Baku City. And also, we've got 10 million people in Azerbaijan right now, but interestingly enough, the more Azerbaijanis live in Iran. And carpets and horses are actually a big thing in Azerbaijan, and the region in the west, Karabakh, is very famous for its carpets and horses. We actually have a game called Chovgan, which was practiced by Azerbaijanis almost 500,000 years ago, and it's very similar to polo. And what happened? Western countries eventually adopted that game and called it polo, and it's very widespread right now in throughout the world. Azerbaijan is a relatively small country, but very interestingly enough, it has got mountains and the beaches. So some people actually say that Azerbaijan has got 9 different climate types. And tea is a big part of Azerbaijani household. Everyone is drinking tea. No one knows about coffee. And I think Azerbaijan is almost top country in the world by tea consumption. I think 99% of Azerbaijanis actually consume tea only. And it's a secular country, interestingly enough, because it lies close to Eastern Europe, Middle East, and Central Asia. But according to some research, Azerbaijan is almost the most secular country in the world. And we've got even entire villages with Christians living in it, Jewish people living in it, and obviously Muslim people living in it. Now I'll pass on to my colleague Rauf to talk about Azerbaijan and Indian relations.
Thank you. I'm going to talk about Azeri and Indian relationship, ties and similarities of these two nations. India recognized Azerbaijan as an independent country in December 1991, soon after we proclaimed our independence from USSR, formally in October 1991. The resident embassy was opened in March 1999, and Azerbaijan's export to India $457 million, import $126 million. Major import products, cereals, machinery, nuclear reactors, boilers, electric and electronic equipment, and of course pharmaceutical products. Logistically, complexity between these two countries were a large issue in the setting up of trade foundation or exploring synergies between these two. But the North-South trade corridor, amongst other wins, is a huge impact to our relationship between these two countries. The other important historical relationship between two countries is the Great Silk Road. Centuries earlier, Indians involved in trading with Caspian region were a regular feature in Azerbaijan. They traded goods such as silk, spices, tea, ivory,
even
cotton.
Ivory.
Yeah. Ivory, cotton, wool, and precious metals. Much of the woodwork for ships on the Caspian Sea was also done by Indian craftsmen. Cultural influence in this country are quite a sight to behold. One of the most important thing for Indians in Azerbaijan is the fire of Baku, fire temple of Baku, which we call Baku Ateshgah. It's a castle-like religious temple just outside of Baku, a multi-religious temple at different points in time. It was used as a Hindu, Sikh, and even Zoroastrian place of worship.
Zoroastrian.
Exactly, yeah. Ateshgah is a world of fire. That's why it's used a lot with Zoroastrianism, and the complex, which has a courtyard surrounded by cells for monks and altar in just in the middle.
So you're saying there are a lot of people coming from India to Azerbaijan?
Yes, every year
just to visit.
Yes,
that one
as
place.
A pilgrims, and it was built during 17th-18th century. And the other thing about our relationship is the very famous name is Sadhguru. So on 8th November 2018, Sadhguru landed in Azerbaijan. He was there on the invitation of the president's daughter, Leyla Aliyeva, who is the president of Yoga Federation. And despite of the jet lag and fatigue from travel, the same day Sadhguru set out on his visit to Fire Temple and the Maiden Tower, and which are cultural heritages of Azerbaijan. Sadhguru's Russian translation book, very famous, it's called Inner Engineering, A Guide to Joy, was presented in Baku Book Center. So now I want to talk a little bit about yoga.
So I know you've got personal ties with yoga.
Yes.
You personally have been exposed to Indian culture.
First time I started my yoga practices in 2008, and it was just one teacher in Azerbaijan, Baku, and around 10-15 students. But now it's so surprisingly, like, it's growing in popularity in Azerbaijan. And as we know, yoga is a series of exercise, combines physical, mental, and spiritual practices. And the origin of yoga, of course, is India, and the world itself, like yoga world, is derived from Sanskrit and means to join or unite. So it helps unite people in Azerbaijan and in India and unite two nations as well.
And would I be right if I say you are one of the first yoga practitioners in Azerbaijan?
Yes, and I even went to India to continue and learn more about yoga, meditation, and other practices.
Which part of India?
I went to Kerala, south part of India. It's one of the most beautiful states in India, and I've been there actually two times. A yoga and poetry night has been arranged as a part of World Literature Project held in Yanar Dagh State Historical Culture and Natural Reserve. The International Yoga Day is celebrating annually in Baku City 21st of June, and was internationally recognized by the United Nations General Assembly in 2014. The day is observed in many countries, including Azerbaijan and India. The large-scale fifth yoga and health festival has been held in the seaside boulevard in Baku City. And every year, all yoga fans of the city gather at a big festival and celebrate significant event, International Day of Yoga. Also, I want to say between our relationships in a culture and poetry, and even some of other important names are Rashid Begagutov and Raj Kapoor, So Rashid Bekutov is a famous singer who was also a friend with Indian actor Raj Kapoor. Azeri artist Rashid Bekutov also promoted Azeri music both in India and in Azerbaijan. For me personally, India became really attractive for me after reading the book called Shantaram.
You discovered India.
I discovered literally this country for myself, how amazing and incredible it is, and I decided to visit India. So Shantaram is a novel by Gregory Roberts in which Australian bank robber escapes prison and goes to India and went to India. A novel is commended by many for its vivid portrayal of Bombay city and lots of traditions, culture of India in early to late 18th. And yeah, this novel really inspired. I remember it was 2018 when we got a Russian translation of book Shantaram. And it became a bestseller in my country, so all my group mates, all my family members read that book.
Hello.
Yeah, I went to India, every single person in my family went to India, like my brother, mother, so they all decided like, oh, this is an amazing country, we see so many similarities and we want to go and enjoy this country. And when I arrived in India, I was feeling like this country is like, I've been in this country before. Personally, I believe in reincarnation, and maybe one of my lives I lived in India and was a part of this amazing country and culture.
You don't need to answer this question, but what do you think? Do you think something has changed in you once you visited India?
Yes.
You don't need to answer it, if it's personal.
I think this country for me is a country where I ask questions, go with some question in my heart and find the answers there. I think I go to the special state of mind and relaxation where the answer comes. And first time I decided to move to Australia from Azerbaijan, and it was a big step for me. I discovered it in India. I asked the question, what do I want for the next 5-10 years? And in India, I found my question. I will go.
You found your answer.
Oh, sorry, I found my answer, yeah.
So actually India led you to
exactly.
Australia.
India led me, connected Azerbaijan and kind of Australia. And now I'm in Australia and enjoying.
That's
and
amazing.
I'm really was surprised how many Indians in Australia. It's a big community. And every year I've been invited to some Diwali parties where I took part, and I was really enjoying that Diwali parties. And I have lots of Indian friends. I love Indian cuisine. And
exactly.
Indian
that's
songs.
That's amazing. Yeah. And tell me about the weddings. I think weddings in Azerbaijan and India, they're very similar.
Yeah.
I think we've got at least 1,000 guests.
1,000 guests.
Visiting Azerbaijani weddings, and I know it's a big thing in India as well.
Yeah, lots of dancing, lots of eating, singing, and like
music.
And sometimes it's not 1 day wedding, it's 3-4 days weddings, like lots, because too many guests you can't accommodate, and you need to do part one, part two, part three. So yeah, it's a big thing. It's big thing in Azerbaijan. It's
all I can say, I think we're actually looking forward to building even closer relationships with Indian community in Australia, and actually building some kind of a friendship tie between Azerbaijan and Indian community. Azerbaijani community in Victoria is quite close to each other. So I think we've got at least 1,000 members in our community, mainly from Azerbaijan, but we also have a lot of people from Iran. And as I said, when I say Azerbaijan, it doesn't really mean one nation. We've got Jewish people, Russian people, Talish people, and also Azerbaijanis themselves. The first wave of Azerbaijanis was around in the 90s when the Soviet Union collapsed and many Azerbaijanis just immigrated in Australia. And the second wave started in probably 2000-2010s when a lot of students came here to study their bachelor's, master's and postdoctorate degrees. So the community is growing, and we, again, as I said, we're looking forward to building more closer relationships.
I think the purpose of this talk was to give some brief information about our country and some relationship between India and Azerbaijan, I think, which we did
pretty
well.
Yeah, and I think we were actually, and also just express our excitement about the communities.
Yeah, and I think we want to invite everyone to come and visit this incredible country called Azerbaijan and enjoy our food.
And everyone should join our annual Nowruz celebration, which happens in spring. It's a spring celebration. We have a lot of food, and the spring is actually the celebration of friendship and family. So they say that people actually, if you don't talk to anyone or you have some bad relationship with anyone, the spring, the Nowruz, is the time when you actually forgive those people and you start your restart your friendship.
Hope you enjoyed our talk, and welcome to Azerbaijan. Yeah.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.